Hey there, welcome back to Clip Studio Paint Quick Tips. My name is Scott Drummond. I'm a comic artist and illustrator. And today we're going to talk about using the fill tool to quickly and easily color your comics in Clip Studio Paint. If you're new here, maybe think about hitting that subscribe button down below and hitting the bell icon next to it to get notified when we're putting up new videos. But this is Quick Tips, so we're not going to waste a whole bunch of time. Let's get into it. Now in our last episode, we used the fill tool to fill in the black areas of our ink drawing. But if we want to color this in, there's a few different ways we can do that. The first thing we want to do is create a new layer. To do that, we just have to hit the layer button over here in the layer palette. Then we want to move this layer by clicking and dragging it below the inks layer. We do this so the inks will show up on top of the color. Then we'll double click on the layer name to rename it something like color, just to stay organized. We'll also want to check to make sure this layer is actually a color layer. Right here it's set to monochrome, which means it'll only be black and white. To change it, just click and go to color. Now there's a couple different ways we can go about this. One is to use something like the pen tool and draw an area to fill in. When doing this, I usually set the anti-aliasing all the way down. Once we have that area blocked in, we can just click inside of it with the fill tool and it'll fill our area in with color. This is a great way to be really precise about your flat colors, but you can also speed up the process by using your inks layer as a reference layer. Let me show you what I mean. With the fill tool selected, just check Refer Multiple in the tool property palette. Then you can use this dropdown to choose what else you'd like the fill tool to reference. I'm gonna choose Reference Layer. Currently, we don't have any reference layers, but it's really easy to set one up. Just select your inks layer in the layer palette and then click this little lighthouse icon over here to set it as a reference layer. When I'm doing this, I also like to turn anti-aliasing off and turn area scaling on. This way I get nice crisp edges to select later, but also go a little bit under the inks. Now when I fill in these areas, the fill tool sticks to the areas defined by the inks, which is fantastic. It's so much easier than having to outline each area before you fill it in. Using reference layers also works great when you have a bunch of background lines that you want to ignore. Because my inks layer is set as a reference layer, the fill tool is ignoring all the lines on the background layer. And that's about it for some quick coloring tips in Clip Studio Paint. If you found this video helpful, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below. And maybe hit the bell icon to get notified when we put up new videos. We're excited to do a lot more of these quick tips, so make sure to check out the playlist with all of them below. And as always, get out there and make some great comics.